that Bado issue. It is not this issue of aimless, patrol.
What aspect of, or how does this community policing, which you say is in operation at the moment, how does it address posting the indigents who are in the police in their locality to ensure they get this, for instance, it could be the CPs, it could be the ACPs. How does that address it?
Community policing does not necessarily mean taking policemen to their state of origin. It means collaboration, partnership, consent, and transparency. The greatest problem now why community policing is not working. These seven officers trained.
Okay, pardon me. We need to go to break, but we'll find out why isn't it working and what should we do. Don't go away. All right, welcome back. You were going to tell us, why isn't the concept or the one that has been practiced, community policing, why isn't it working now?
It's not working in Nigeria today. It is not easy for the policemen to accept change from the old system. So you need to persevere. You need to persist. You need to have funds to continue training them on the new system of policing, that is community policing.
Are you implying that the policemen are not willing to get back to serving the people instead of being lording it over them?
So you understand what I said? They were lording before. For you to change them, for you to get the best, you must persist. It is not easy to move from old change. It is coming as a new thing to the Nigerian police. And the train of community policing is coming as, this global community policing is coming as a new concept.
Sorry.
So what we require is, if we maintain, for now, most of the community development officers are not doing anything.
Real quick. The kind of training that is gotten from the training school does not include serving the people?
No, it includes serving the people. But what I'm talking in, before, the colonial masters trained our policemen to serve people. But what we are talking now is community policing. You see, everybody is shouting on community policing. But the problem is, it's a new concept of policing. And you need to constantly train the men. They have trained about six commands. But they stopped. Are you getting my point? And transparency to corruption steps in and lack of fund. To continue the training.
Even though you say it's been on since 1984. But let's go to Abuja for more on this. Ajuri. Oh, yeah, thank you, Ajuri. Let's talk about some of the issues that they also raised there, following up on operationalizing those directives as it's been given. Now, if they were to go ahead and implement it, because we do know that they give that directive to several security agencies, let's look at the police for a start. Now, if that has to happen, they have to involve the community. And we know that the communities in this country differ from one community to the other.
Even
the culture. Crime also differ from community to community. So what do you expect from this report? Are they going to have a one-size-fits-all kind of policy, or is it that they have policies for different communities and localities or regions, as it were?
You see, same thing, like what the other man said, in this country, a lot of policies, paperwork. For Nigerian police to succeed, they have already started this community policing.
But you say it's not working.
These seven officers trained for Nigerian police, they should be brought back. The way they were implementing community policing before, it went down around 1987. Some of these officers were posted out from that office, some went to the command. One of them is an AIG now. You bring those seven officers back because they were trained in America and Britain. In America, it was MacArthur Foundation. In Britain, it was GFID. You bring them back and give them, say, I give you 1 year. Go and make sure that community policing is implemented in all parts of this country. And it requires funding.
Now, let's look at some practical steps. Because, look, these communities you speak about, on the streets, for instance, the policemen that the citizens or residents meet first and foremost. And look, if you ask anyone on the street now, they'll tell you, look, they're driving on the road, they jump in front of their cars. They don't have that trust on the part of the police and the community. So if you were to implement this one, how, what exactly are we going to see? Are we going to see them keep jumping in front of the cars? Will they come to the communities and relate to them differently? Will it be led by the community or will it be led by the police?
It will be led by the police. It will be led by a national orientation agency. We need to educate our community what we mean by community policing. And on the side of the police, there must be transparency. You must make the members of the public to have the trust in you. Once they have the trust in you, and the communities are educated on what we call community policing, they will key into it. It's a good concept, and it's different from state police.
So the structure won't be a problem?
It won't be a problem. The only thing I'm telling you is that we have men trained in community policing. 5 officers, 7 officers, bring them back, give them the mandate, give them the fund, make sure you implement community policing within 1 year, they will do it. Instead of setting up all these committees that go and write papers and present, those boys are practical police officers. They will do it. Now, we have 4 officers in the police force today that can do something. Those 7 officers, they are sound officers, intelligent officers. They can implement community policing in Nigeria within 1 year.
Well, are you underestimating getting the trust of the people? Because it's not even just the police, even with the army and several security agencies. The people feel it's us and them. So they have to breach that trust first for this to work.
Yes. In the community policing program, they teach you how to politeness, how to manage the members of the public. It's a course. It's a complete course. A book, right. Very big book. It's a complete course. So when they teach you, and we move it to colleges, it will be a course in all police colleges.
All right. I'm afraid we're out to anchor at that point. We've been speaking with Mr. Ibezimako Ahaya, who is a former commissioner of police in Ekiti, Benue, as well as Kogi State. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you, Chairman.
We're back in a moment. Stay with us.